إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، إنه من يهدي الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله، فصلى الله عليه صلاة وسلاما يليقان بمقام سيد الأنبياء وإمام المرسلين. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran always reminds us to be thankful, to show gratitude to everyone around us, especially gratitude with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says in the Quran, بعد أن أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ وَلَإِنْ كَفَرْتُمْ إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has declared, has announced that if you were to be thankful, if you show gratitude, I will always increase you. And if you are ungrateful, you have to know that my punishment is severe. And that's why part of our taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, one of the arkan of the khutbah is to remind the community about taqwa of Allah. But before that, I started by saying being thankful is an introductory phase to show taqwa of Allah. Because Allah says, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. Believers, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and try your best to end your life in a state of submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Back to this topic of gratitude. Al-Imam al-Bayhaqi narrates an interesting story that a man came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. رجلاً أتى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يسأل فأعطاه تمرة. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave him one date. And the guy did not like that. Ya Rasulullah, I came to you expecting for a lot more. He said, Subhanallah, نبي من الأنبياء يتصدق بتمرة. A prophet of Allah who was given so much, he's giving me one date only. فقال له النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, أما علمت أن فيها مثاقيل در كثيرة؟ Don't you know that this date, in and within of itself, it has a lot of benefits. It has a lot, it's a lot. One date or one sip of water in the desert where you don't have anything else is a lot. That's a lot of carbs, a lot of nutrition benefits. It's very healthy for you. So subhanAllah, the guy went away. He was dissatisfied with getting a tamra, a date, from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And by the way, the hadith, there's some questioning of its authenticity, but we're mentioning it for the benefit of it, inshallah. فأتاه آخر فسأله فأعطاه. Another man showed up and asked for the Prophet ﷺ to give him something, and he gave him one date. And the guy was amazed. He was ecstatic about it. He loved it. He said, تمرة من نبي. I got one thing from a Prophet, even if it was a date. والله لا تفارقني هذه الثمرة ما بقيت. I won't even eat it because this is a souvenir. This is a gift, a beloved gift from a beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I will always keep it with me. وَلَا أَزَالُ أَرْجُو بَرَكَتَهَا أَبَدًا. And I know there is a lot of blessings involved in this date. This is why, because of this, I won't even eat it. فَأَمَرَ لَهُ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ بِمَعْرُوفٍ. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told those who helped him, give him more actually. Allahu Akbar. لَإِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. If you show gratitude, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will always increase you. So the two men got the same gift from the same man, but one of them appreciated. One of them realized this is a gift from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the narrator mentions, وَمَا لَبِثَ الرَّجُلْ أَنِ اسْتَغْنَى. Very shortly after that man became wealthy in the dunya. And Allah knows best how much he got spiritual reward in the hereafter because of this mindset. because of this attitude of being grateful, appreciating what we got. Even if the economy is not doing well, even if your fridge is half full, at least there is something there. You know, we always say that we should look at the half, you know, empty or half full of the cup. I'm here to tell you, you should be happy that you have a cup. I'm here to tell you, you should be happy that you can see the cup, you can touch it, you can carry it. I'm here to tell you that you should be happy that you still have your mind and your business ideas and your creative innovation and all that stuff, so that you can find other ways how you can fill that cup. I'm here not to tell you look at the positive full of the cup, you know, the full half of the cup and be grateful. I'm here to tell you, you have a lot more than what you have, alhamdulillah. And that's why as a believer, as a Muslim, one of the biggest challenges in this life, it's not about halal or haram. Normally, whenever we have a scholar in town, or whenever we are accompanying a scholar, normally we ask them halal, haram questions. Sheikh, is this halal, is this haram? Is this halal, is this haram? And I get these questions a lot, as you say. كثير من الناس يعنى ويعتقد أن الإسلام موقع الإسلام من حياته هل هذا شيء حلال أو حرام؟ It is not about that. The biggest challenge in Islam, because most of us know what's halal and what's haram, right? The biggest challenge in life, are you going to be grateful with everything that you are given? Are you going to look at the positive half, at the positive side of every difficult situation, even if it was bad? That's why we should understand, first of all, that to build an attitude of gratitude, you should teach yourself to say thank you more, to show gratitude to people. Because Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "من لا يشكر الناس لا يشكر الله." He who does not thank people is not truly thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And let me tell you exactly what that means. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sending us blessings, right? Every blessing you have, you name it, it is coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whether it's food, whether it's water, whether it's oxygen, whether it's your job security, health insurance, everything is coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose not to give us our blessings directly. What does that mean? If Allah wants to provide you with food, normally you get this food through someone. Somebody will cook that food for you, or you go and buy it, or technically that money, somebody has gave you that money so that you can buy the food. If Allah wants to send you the blessing of happiness, Allah will not inject happiness directly in your heart, although it may happen. Normally, Allah will send someone who will tell you a joke, who will be friends with you, who will show you some compassion, some mercy, and you will get to the feeling of happiness that is originally from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but it came to you through that person, right? Similarly, Allah created us, right? But Allah didn't create us in this world out of nothing. We came to this world through parents. So our parents are the direct seen reason for us to be existing on earth. But we all know that it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who willed for this to happen. Allah wants to teach us language, but He teaches us language through our parents, most of the times, who teach us how to talk. Why am I saying this philosophical idea? Because if you do not thank the seen individuals who give you Allah's blessings, you are less likely to thank the unseen provider. Does that make sense? So if someone is feeding you food right now and you can see them, if you do not thank them, you are less likely to thank Allah, the unseen, who gave you that food, right? If you cannot thank those who make you happy, those who help you, those who give you nasiha, even if you don't like the nasiha, you are not likely to thank Allah enough. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَنِشْكُرْ لِي وَلِوَالِدَيْكَ إِلَيَّ الْمَصِيرِ. Show gratitude to me and to your parents, because to me is the final return and destination. So if you don't thank your parents enough, you are not thanking Allah enough. And if you're not showing gratitude to your spouse, to your husband or to your wife, you know, between husband and wife, there's a lot of conflicts. There's a lot of trouble. There's a lot of, you forgot to do this, you forgot to do that. There's a lot of, oh, she didn't cook that maqluba well for me. And he did not pick up the trash after he finished food. There's a lot of this going on, right? But if you do not show gratitude to your spouse more than the complaints, you are not thanking who? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why Allah tells the spouses, وَلَا تَنْسَوُ الْفَضْلَ بَيْنَكُمْ. And do not forget, do not ignore gratitude between you. Brothers and sisters, my khutbah today, my message is very simple. One of the quickest ways to seek direct line of connection and communication with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to show gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you cannot do this without thanking people, thanking everyone and everyone. There was this guy who did the experiment, and now in social media, there's a lot of social experiments. This guy who decided to write a thank you note for one person a day. Like, today, I have to thank someone. And I have to be creative. So first time, maybe he thanked his spouse, maybe the other day, his kids, then following day, his neighbors. And I think he reached more than 1,000 thank you letters within 2 or 3 or 4 years. And guess what? His mental health, his well-being got improved. Because he realized, subhanAllah, there's a lot of people who care for him. There's a lot of people who love him and, you know, want to his companionship and friendship. So one of the best ways to feel better about every situation is to thank people and, of course, to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and show gratitude. Brothers and sisters, we are getting through a lot of turmoil in our community, in our country. We have an election coming very soon. Allahu a'lam what's going to happen. Yes, we have a lot of reasons to complain about everything and anything that's happening to us, but let us show gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because there are so many things happening that are good in our life, and when we are thankful to Allah, this is the entry, inshallah, for Allah to increase us in our wealth. When you are thankful, you realize you have a responsibility. Yes, let me go and try to tip these elections a little bit in the lesser of two evils. Let me do this, let me do that. When you have a gratitude mindset, wallahi, you will own your life. And you will own your circumstances. Your circumstances will not own you and control you. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ الْعَظِيمَ لِي وَلَكُمْ. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى لا سيما نبينا المصطفى ومن بسنته وآثاره اقتدى واقتفى واكتفى. Brothers and sisters, again, the message of today's khutbah, be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and make sure that Iblis, back in the days, when he rejected Allah, and when he confronted Allah with his challenge, Iblis told Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ثُمَّ لَآتِيَنَّهُمْ. I will come to them, to those children of Adam that you favored upon me. ثُمَّ لَآتِيَنَّهُمْ مِنْ بَيْنِ أَيْدِيهِمْ. I will come to them from the front. وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِمْ, and from the back. وَعَنْ أَيْمَانِهِمْ, even when they do good deeds, I will come to them from their right. وَعَنْ شَمَائِلِهِمْ, and from their left. And Iblis challenged Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلَا تَجِدُ أَكْثَرَهُمْ شَاكِرِينَ. And most of them will be ungrateful to you, Ya Allah. This is the bottom line. Yes, Iblis might suggest to you to try smoking, or to try drinking, or to look at that haram scene, or to try that haram relationships. But the end result of all of this, Iblis wants you to become an ungrateful being who does not appreciate Allah at all, who does not thank people at all, who's always pessimistic and sad and gloomy. Are you going to meet Iblis's expectation, or are you going to be different? Iblis said, وَلَا تَجِدُ أَكْثَرَهُمْ شَاكِرِينَ. Most of them won't be thankful, but some will be thankful. And inshallah, all of us in this room will be among the few who are grateful, inshallah ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَقَلِيلٌ مِّنْ عِبَادِيَ الشَّكُورِ. Only a few of my slaves, of my servants, will be thankful. Inshallah, all of us and those who will listen to us, because I beg you, please share this positive message with others to be grateful. So please, let's be among the few who show gratitude to people around us and to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك أن نضل أو نضل أو نزل أو نزل أو نظلم أو نظلم أو نجهل أو يجهل علينا. اللهم أصلح لنا ديننا الذي هو عصمة أمرنا، وأصلح لنا دنيانا التي فيها معاشنا، وأصلح لنا آخرتنا التي إليها معادنا، واجعل الحياة زيادة لنا في كل خير، واجعل الموت راحة لنا من كل شر. اللهم لك الحمد، اللهم لك الحمد، اللهم لك الحمد، اللهم لك الحمد كله، ولك الشكر كله، وإليك يرجع الأمر كله، على نيته وسره. اللهم ألهمنا الحمدك يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارزقنا لسانا ذاكرا، وجسدا على البلاء صابرا، وقلبا شاكرا يا رب العالمين يا الله. وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.